Hello and welcome to another episode of LEGO Minifigures Online. We haven't done one of these for quite some time, but in this episode we're going to be getting the achievements for the Pretzel Girl. It was requested in the comments by, I think, Rowan Gal that this would be the next minifigure to get achievements for. So we need to head on over to the achievement section. Actually, it would be a good idea to check what series this figure is. That's not where you go to check that. There we go. Now I have to go and find it. Okay, it's not that series. It's not. Oh, it's 11. Okay, now we can go and find it. We've only got 2 out of 16, so there's a lot to get. The Mysterious Cave. Alien Commander. So these, I guess, are dungeons. That's a boss. Color of the Fungo Mons. I know where that one is. Build 100 buildies. Build 1,000 buildies. Build 30 signs. We can do the 30 signs. Level 5. Level 10. Level 15. Okay, so I guess we could do some of these today. Probably won't be doing the Lost Creations ones. Let's go to a place where they have signs, which is pretty much everywhere, but we'll start with the Isle of Yar. We need to build 30. We can simultaneously try and research where on earth those dungeons are. Okay, we're here, and a sign should be around this corner. That's one. Oh, there's another sign. And that's another one. Now, they have these signs everywhere. I guess we just keep following the paths around and we'll encounter signs. I don't think we even have to leave this world. We can just teleport back to the beginning again. Someone didn't finish this one off. Aha! There we go. Oh yeah, they changed the layout of this slightly. Can we go up here? Yes, you defeat him. And then he gets teleported up to the top.
It's a dangerous path, but we have no other choice. This way.
Well, that's one way to skip the dialogue. I thought there would be a sign, but I think there's probably one over here somewhere. No, not yet. There are a lot of signs at the beginning. That was for sure. Oh, there's one. I was thinking we must come across one at some point soon. Here come the bricks. I've actually lost count of how many we've gotten. It's got to be near 10 by now, so I have a feeling we're most of the way there. And building these things will help towards the 100 buildies achievement as well, I think. That's another one. I didn't have that achievement? Okay, well, I guess we didn't walk all the way after that update. Cool, we got a different achievement. No, no signs. Alright then. Do we need to go up here? We're not really looking to complete any quests. Sort of a detour going this way, actually. Yeah, as I was saying, when they released that update, that made the game buy to play. Since we already completed most of the game before then, they added like a bunch of new achievements we didn't get, so there's lots of really easy ones in the beginning levels that I didn't manage to pick up, and that was the right way. Oh no, but I don't think there's going to be another sign. Well, there might have been, but there doesn't look like there's any of those break stops. There's usually only signs. Does this count as a buildable? I don't know if it does. You sort of unbuild it. You get a trophy for unbuilding it. Yeah, have some snow. Have some snow, ghost pirates. I don't really see the advantage of becoming a ghost pirate here, since it doesn't really give them any special abilities. They just still die. Well, there are some buildable stuff here. There's no signs, but there are these cannons, which summon some pirate allies. It's nice. We don't actually need them, but it's nice that they're there anyway. Let's teleport back to the beginning and do that all over again. We're actually going to start right from the beginning this time. We chose to skip the beginning teleporter because I thought there might not be any signs, but there might be. If there's not, then I won't be starting from this bit again. Okay, looks like there are no signs. There's a sign. Alright, let's start this journey again. We might have to do this 3, maybe even 4 times. I think we're not actually going to go all the way either, because there's lots of signs at the beginning. I think it's best just to go back and forth between the more densely populated areas. It doesn't really take much walking to get between these signs. Or we can just teleport at the beginning again. And it's when it gets past that cutscene place is where the signs start to drop off a bit. Another sign. I think it's around here, isn't it? This is where the final cutscene is, so we're just going to teleport back to the beginning now. How exciting. I don't know how long it takes for signs to unbuild themselves. Apparently it takes them a short amount of time because that one is still there. So, I don't know, maybe I do have to actually walk a bit more. There we go. Don't build it. I think he built it. Why is he wants stars. He's trying to farm stars. I guess I can see why. Maybe this area has a lot of stars. A lot of smashy stuff. But, yeah, I don't really... I mean, stars are extra, and I'm very happy to get stars. But we're here for the signs! We want the signs! Build the sign. Yes. The other sign should have definitely been unbuilt by now. There we go. I like how it just instantly builds it as well. It's to do with the level difference. We're quite a high level, so it builds faster. And we're, of course, a builder character. We're not really in combat, though. I mean, we are in combat, but they can't really deal any damage to us. Alright. You know, he could do all the work, and we can collect the stars. It's like a brilliant plan because of the shared star thing. So by the time we go back, he's going to have farmed a lot more stars, and we can pick those up too. So thanks, whoever you are, collecting stars. And build. So the time is just about right, actually, in between signs. This is quite a nice little circuit we've got here. We've got someone farming stars that we can collect after we teleport back. And by the time we reach these signs, they more or less disintegrate and rebuild themselves. We do have to sort of stop for a few seconds, but still. Alright, now we can teleport back and do it all over again. I think Far, he quit. He's not doing this anymore. He gave up. He's got enough stars for whatever he wants. We are gonna wait. There we go. Might as well collect some stars and copy what he did until that sign has come back. You know, after this round, I'm going to check how many we've got left to go. Can't be that many. Got to nearly be done. We'll let him deal with the guards. We don't really want to smash the guards, we want the signs. Oh, we haven't got it yet. No, what are the chances of this one being the last one? Apparently none. Right, we're going to teleport back. And we're going to check our achievements. Oh, he's collecting them again. That's cool. Pretzel Girl. 5 more signs. Okay. Nope, not unbuilt yet. Is there anything else to smash? Right, so that's 2 out of 5 left. We're building those for the building achievement. These count towards the buildy thingy as well. After this, we're not going to specifically go after that building achievement because there are some other things that we can do achievement-wise, like smash bosses and do dungeons. And I'm sure there'll be buildy stuff along the way to those. So probably one more circuit then. Oh no, that was the 5th one. Great. I keep stop counting for some reason. Whenever enemies come, I'm like, oh no, enemies! Better stop counting. I am going to go back one more time though, because that guy's going to have left a lot of stars, and I want to collect them. That was a lot of stars. Alright, thanks buddy. I'm gonna head out of here. Or not. Yeah, that really works. Okay, so what's next? Check the achievements. Let's go to the mysterious crystal cave, which I have to look where that is. It's probably... Oh, I'm not even going to guess, because it could be in any of the worlds, to be honest. Mysterious Crystal Cave is not in the pirate world. It's not in the kingdom world. It is in the Enchanted Forest. I was going to guess the Enchanted Forest, but then sometimes you can get these places in the space world. I know that because of all the environment and it's spacey, can have these things. Alright, whereabouts is the mysterious crystal cave? It's the 2nd dungeon, so wherever the 2nd dungeon is, we've got to go to it. Luckily it's the, well, this one anyway, because the enemies won't be that tough, and we don't have to worry about being attuned to the dungeon. We can just enter in. Then again, it is the crystal cave. Which would mean... Oh, the crystal cave. It's that one. Oh, hey, buildables. We might as well, instead of teleporting there, build the buildables and walk there. Alright, well... build these signs. There's a lot of those signs, actually, so this'll be good. I remember the crystal cave now. It's that one outside the crystal mine. There are a lot of these grandma signs. Another speed build pad. Avoid the wolves. Oh, cool. One of these things. It's made this area infinitely easier now. Let's take the shortcut. Nothing to build here. Oh wait, there is. There's the speed pad thing. Where is a sign? There should be a sign somewhere. Or I guess not. There's nothing to build here. That's okay. Maybe if we went the other way. Since this is sort of a side path, side route. Yeah, it's a side route. Oh, there is a sign. There's a normal sign. One of those signs. The mysterious crystal cave. Defeat the champion. I will definitely defeat him. But we're not going to use the pretzel girl, because... well, she doesn't really do as much damage as these guys. Oh, that was a one-hit smash. Oh, this is the tic-tac-toe boss. Okay, now this is... oh, he healed him! Which one's the healer? I'm gonna go after you, Tick. No, a bad time to show that. Thank you very much. But now these are so much easier to smash now that Tick is gone. Nice. We conquered the mysterious crystal cave. What else do we need to conquer? What is the other dungeon? It is... the Alien Command Center. Well, that is most definitely in the space world. It is the last boss, or last dungeon of the dark side of the planet. And here it's called Planet's Dark Side. Okay, maybe it's here. Is this the Alien Command Center? No, it's not. Is it that epic dungeon? Is it the one that's here? No, wait. Here. Alien Command Center. Right, we're gonna need to equip a tech guy. Who do we want to replace? I think the wizard. And which one is the wizard? I think it's 12. Yeah, for the wizard, don't we have like a smashy achievement thingy we need to do? Smash 10,000 monsters as wizard. Is that the same for the forest maiden as well? Smash 5,000 smashies. Oh, smashies, not monsters. Alright, so we can temporarily switch out the forest maiden. We need a tech. Let's do let's go to the space. Nope, not space. Alien trooper. There we go. I think that's okay. Yeah, he matches the attunement. We had to do that because the space world enemies are actually sort of tough, so if we use the other characters, like let's try the wizard. That'll just take forever to get through this dungeon, and we're not going to spend all day doing this. Actually, do we even need to fight? Why fight when you can run away? Yeah, we can just skip all of these. Skip them as the wizard, because we need the health on the alien trooper. Right, now we have to fight. But that's okay. We're ready. We've got our spaceship. A little UFO. We can dodge these. Gotta re-destroy those cannons because... There we go, they're gone. Now we only have to worry about dealing with the waves when they spawn. I think that's the boss. Right, they've all been caught, except for that one at the back in the UFO's beam. I like it if you target, if you manage to actually hit the enemy with your sonic beam, it makes the UFO deal more damage to the enemies. That's cool. Alright, here's some more enemies that I keep forgetting that we can just skip. So, wizard time. Nope, another boss. Let's place another UFO down. Here comes some more enemies. I've got a chest. Might as well open it. It's free. Let's keep moving. Right, where to next? I think this might be the last dungeon as well for this figure. No, we're not going to be completing this quest. This is a pretty large dungeon. There are a lot of enemies to fight, but we're not here to fight. If we were, we would have equipped some more tech characters because we would have been able to deal with them better. Right, who's next? Another boss, Slark. Oh! His ship's come to help him out, that's cool. Wasn't good enough though, but it was still cool. Ah, Vespid colonies. That is a lot of Vespids. I don't like Vespids. Luckily the UFO deals with them quite well. Four. Those aren't very effective defense turrets. Because they take ages to charge up, so by the time they actually shot me, I was bouncing away. Alien Commander Z. Oh, this is the last guy. The Alien Commander. Once we defeat him, we get the achievement. Wait a second. No, we don't. I need to actually... Can we switch minifigures? I've done something terribly wrong. Yes, we can. I accidentally switched out the Pretzel Girl. I didn't have her equipped anymore. That would have been disastrous. We would have had to start this all over again. But now it's okay. Yeah, no, that's not really doing the job. Back to the Alien Commander again. Well, not the Alien Commander, the Alien Trooper. We actually need to get out of here because it's so slow. We should be able to destroy it before it kills us. And there we go. And his ship explodes into tiny pieces. Nice, we got an achievement, and an achievement for completing an achievement. How do we get out of here? Here we go. Alright, let's equip the Forest Maiden again. So that we can get credit for the smashing the smashies. Back to Pretzel Girl. Alright, what's next? We've got to find that boss, I think. There is a boss. No, 11. 11. Yes. You mad Thunder Crusher. Oh, there's three bosses. Alright, well, we just need to find wherever. You mad Thunder Crusher. So he's probably hanging out somewhere in either the medieval or mythology world, maybe? Yeah, he's in the medieval world, one of them. Which one is he in? Is he in the kingdom or the enchanted forest? Luckily, Google has all the answers. He's in the kingdom. And okay, he's over there. Great. Right, now we can teleport off to where he is. You mad Thunder Crusher? That's not the kingdom. Here we come. Actually, might as well start looking for the next one as well. What's the next one called? We know that one is, so where's Morduk? The underhanded. Yeah, because Clora the Fungo Monster, we know that that one's in the Enchanted Forest Zone. Where is Morduk? There we go, Mythology World. Right, we know where everyone is. Now we can just go and smash them. Ah, Buildy, Buildy. Can't forget the Buildy. Here he is, you mad Thunder Crusher. You know, have a avalanche of snow. You mad, bro? Nah, not particularly. Not today, anyway. Oh, we've never actually smashed that one, so we got two achievements. Right. Time to go and find Clora the Fungomancer. Yep, it's around here. And oh, you have to build those things, don't you? You didn't have to do that before, but after like an update, you do now. We've defeated this boss before. In one of the other achievement hunting videos. Where's the other mushroom tower? I think there's a few of them. Here's one. Ew, spiders, no. I think this might be too far away. Yeah, it is. Alright, we've built two of the towers. Now, where are the other ones? Is there one over here? Nope, we're just there. and we built that one already. That's the other one. So maybe this way is where we'll find the other towers. Apparently not. No, okay, no, not that way. Is there any in this creepy spider cave place? I don't think there is. I'd be very surprised if there was. It's just a chest. I like it's not even a large chest, it's like a tiny chest. Like after you've braved all the mini spiders, you get a tiny chest. I've done that one. So not that way. Let's try up here. Nope. Not here. For some reason they're fighting the spiders. It's not along the top. Ah, here it is. We were going the right way. Right, there's one. Ah, okay, it's starting to do its thing now. They've been turned into normal mushrooms, and they're not like stone mushrooms. I bet the boss is here. Yep, here's the boss. And that worked! We just dumped a lot of snow on them and eventually they were smashed. Alright, let's head off to the mythology world. Can we please teleport somewhere safe? No, we can't teleport during combat. Right, now we have some time to think. Where is that boss? Hold on, we have the map here. Who were they again? Oh yeah, Morduk, the underhanded. And they are sort of in the middle. Since we're going to the Ogre Mountains, I'm guessing it roams around there. Okay. Let's climb up this mountain. Prove your strength? They're not today. We're gonna just prove our dodging skills. Here he is. That was not effective at all. Oh, it is the mythology world. Of course, they are tougher enemies. Well, we have the wizard for that. Apparently we've never defeated him before either. Oh, Buildy. Or Unbuildy. Yes, we got a purple thing. It looks like in each world there's something to collect by unbuilding stuff. I don't know, I guess one day we have to go through slowly on each world and see if we can find all those things. Well, that's that. Let's check what else we've got to do. So the Pretzel Girl needs the 7th Pretzel Girl upgrade. We can do that now. It's only 3 more upgrades to go. When using your special attack, if you are hit, you heal a small amount. When using your special attack, you cannot be moved. Oh, I want to be healed. That's cool. It means you can use it for free heals. More damage? Okay. When you hit an enemy, you heal a small amount. Is that hit with just your fists, or is that your special? If it's your special, that's really good. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. This is the 7th. We've eaten through a lot of stars to get there. No, we're not going to get the last one. Right, so that's that achievement done. Basically, now we can't take damage? Because we just heal forever using that attack? Is that how it works? I mean, yeah, we can. It has no recharge, so we can just keep doing this. That's fun. Just smashing ogres with this ice thing. I actually do want to teleport away, but I keep encountering ogres for some reason. There's just a lot of them here. Please let this be a safe area. Okay, what's next? Achievements? Pretzel. To get 11, we need to do one more. So that's 1,000 buildies! We are not doing that today. We could get to level 5, I guess, but takes a small amount of time. More buildies! I guess, where's a good place for buildies? I don't know, I wonder if we can research this. There's probably a good area for buildable stuff. So I think the best idea is to probably head back to the Enchanted Forest zone, since there are a lot of signs around this place. Because of we counted loads of these count as buildies. So we need to do we're at 55, so we need 45 left. That's now slightly less because we've built those. But we'll check our progress after we reach the end. This is probably going to make it quite a long video doing all these building stuff, but you know, it's probably worth it in the end. It means we'll get a glow for this figure. And it'll be one more sort of ticked off the list. And we're not aiming for 100% on all the minifigures yet. We've still got so many to go that can get achievements. Oh, that was it. Alright, so we're going to go back and teleport again. There was what, like, 6 or so things we built? Now we'll count them this time. That's 1. This is 2. I don't think we built that last time. This is 3. Oh, there's a missing sign here. Okay, that's 4. This is 5. This is 6. That hasn't come back yet. Then that would be 7. So there's potentially 7, but those take a while to unbuild themselves. There's loads of these, though. So that's good. And we're eventually going to complete these quests one way or the other. Might be worth dropping an avalanche here. That was worth it. Okay. Next sign. I guess something to make this a bit faster would be to use one of those characters with the speed boost. So with the speed pads it makes 7. So there's about 5 of those signs. Yeah, two speed pads and 5 signs. The muffin. Or some sort of cake. I think it's a cake. So at the minimum we'll be getting 5 buildies per sort of, I was going to call it a run, but it's really just a more of a light walk through the forest. Which means we've already sort of done quite a few of these now, but I don't know, there's only about 7 more of these runs to go, and we should be done. Maybe less. That was it. Right, We're getting faster at this. And we get like 3 stars each time, so every little star helps. Yeah, this is definitely the best place to do this. I keep going over. I don't need to actually leave the safe zone place, but I keep doing it for some reason. Oh well. Nope, I don't want to summon an avalanche. There we go. That sign's not built. So, instead of talking about signs for the last bit of the video, which is probably very boring, we should talk about what's gonna be coming next. Well, the new Series 15 minifigures? Yeah, Series 15 minifigures are out, and I'll be making a video on those very soon. Like the other one, it'll just be an overview of every single minifigure, talking about their elements, the abilities they have, and where they might be useful. I won't be spending really, I don't think, any stars on them at first. I'll be leaving that for like later videos. As for more minifigures online content going forward, since the only new content they seem to be adding to the game for now is more minifigures from the series LEGO releases, I'll probably be just doing achievement videos like this, trying to get at least the glow on all the minifigures. There's a lot of minifigures in the game, so that'll take quite a while to do. I might be doing some more Lost Creations. I can't promise, because Lost Creations isn't exactly an easy thing to do solo. It's much better with at least one other player. It's very slow going solo, and you can only get so far. But the best place, there we go, 100 buildies, so we got it! And the glow, it's now green. The best place to do minifigure testing is either the Mythology or Dino World. I'll probably go back to the Dino World since it's the highest level place that's currently in the game, except for the Lost Creations. Yeah, we just got the achievement for the Pretzel Girl. We're still missing 4 achievements, but that's like 1,000 buildies, and that's not gonna be happening today. I don't feel like doing that run backwards and forwards hundreds and hundreds of times. But what I might do in the future is make videos where I collect minifigures with similar achievements together like this and just go at it and try and get them. And Lost Creations, you just have to have this figure in the back and use 2 other ones, I guess, to boost it to 15. But that will take a run today. I don't think getting to level 15 takes long, but getting to level 15 solo takes a small while. So yeah, we're going to end the video here. It's definitely been a longer one, but it's nice to come back to doing these again. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.